War Measures Act was applied in 1942, suspending all rights of citizenship. Property confiscated, bank accounts frozen, and my dad was shipped off to a road camp near Revelstoke. And there must have been so much anger. You know, what do you do? All the power is here. And, you know, although they may look different from Canadians, but they're Canadians, and they're the frustration. What can you do? You got no power. And you do what they tell you. The Japanese have this expression, gambari, which means you just suck it in, and I guess it's the equivalent of a stiff upper lip. But you just have to tough it out. And what I see there is resignation. Like, what can he do? They're helpless. And that is so reminiscent of, you know, being on a cattle car. I mean, it could very well be a cattle car. Eh?
Oh, give me land, lots of land, under starry skies above. Don't fence me in.
We're allowed 70 pounds of luggage each, put in a train and shipped to what we call Ghost Town.
Don't fence me in.
The little girl looks just like my sister.
In the evening breeze.
For my dad and mother, it must have been an absolutely brutal time, because suddenly the country that they were born and raised in said, look, you're not trustworthy. I grew up not even being aware of the reality of being Japanese. I was just a Canadian kid. Just saying this, they were really Japanese. I guess that's why people thought of them as we're funny looking and had different eating habits. I mean, look at the walls. It's paper. And it used to get brutally cold in this valley. It was. I don't remember this, but I was coming back from school. My dad was waiting, and he could see along the tracks his kid running and falling, and these kids chasing him and then getting up and running and falling, and they were hitting him, and it was me. And those are Japanese kids chasing me coming home from school, because I was one of the few kids that couldn't speak Japanese. So they were all picking on me. I remember when my dad came and rescued me, but I don't remember much else of that. But I was a loner in the camps because, as I say, most kids had parents that came from Japan, so they were fluently bilingual, whereas my mom and dad had never been to Japan and only spoke English, so I was I was a freak among Japanese kids, and they'd... well, that's my first real encounter with discrimination, was from other Japanese kids. So it makes it hard when white people don't want to have anything to do with you, and Japanese kids don't want to do stuff with you.